Hello crafty friends, Luise Heinzel here. Welcome to a video that's called hashtag Corona Crafting. So that's a little bit weird as the whole situation in this world is at the moment. And yeah, let me just explain you a little story, some facts about this video title. As you perhaps know, in the summertime I'm in my caravan. Excuse me. And I have all my craft supplies in this caravan. And in winter, I'm in my normal home where I, yeah, do my digital stuff, my videos and such things. And at the moment, I'm here at my home where nearly no craft supplies are. And of course, I thought, okay, I can go to my caravan, catch something up and do some crafting as well. But the situation, as you know, is that we can't go out of the house, so that it's a necessary thing that we stay at home. And I think that's a really good thing when you do that, by the way, and don't go out of the house if it's not necessary. And so the situation is that I can't go to the camping site because it's closed at the moment, because of course we have to go to the same toilets and the same showers and such things. So I can't go to my crafty area at the moment. And yeah, so I thought it was a little joke when I said to my friends and the ladies from my design team, so hi design team, I said, okay, I do some Corona crafting, because we talked about things, what are you doing, how is the situation where you are, because we come from different countries and such things. And I thought I made a joke when I saw when I said I will use this hashtag Corona Crafting. But when I then posted the project that I will show you in this video yesterday on my Instagram feed, and I used this hashtag and I wrote Corona Crafting, then my Instagram said this hashtag is already existing and there are more than 100 postings with this hashtag. And I thought, okay, what's that? So I posted my own thing and then I clicked this hashtag and I found really, really much postings with this hashtag. And so I thought, okay, what's going on there? And that was so funny. And I told that to my design team ladies and they had to laugh so much. But I think even if this is really funny, there are many people that are at home like me without craft supplies, or it seems that they are without craft supplies. And this video and perhaps some following, I don't know what I can come up with in the future, but this video is all about what can you do when you are at home and you think, okay, I have nothing. So like when you are in a situation like me. And I would like to show you some things that you can do, even if you think you have nothing. This video mainly is about building your stash so that you can use up some things, some junk and stuff to build up your stash. And when this whole weird situation is over, then perhaps you can go to your normal crafty area and make something with this stash. So what I did in the last few days, I ordered some heavy copy paper from Amazon, and I had some onions and onion skins, and I dyed some paper sheets with those onion skins. And what you can see here is a pre-made tag that I made out of it. So I ironed my paper after I dyed it with these onion skins, and then I cut those into these little tags. So I was lucky that I found an old cutting machine here in my house. So I don't know where this thing is from, but I found it. Of course, you can also cut this with your scissors, and you can measure it with your ruler or something like that. So I made some different sizes. And what you also can do to make those tags is you can make such such a template for them. So I took this packaging here. So this is some cardstock from a food packaging, and I measured this thing so that I if I want them all the same width, I can take this here, put it to something. Let me just pick up here some prepared things. My desk is a little bit too small for this. So yeah, even if you have some white paper or something like that, you can take the thing here and you can put it to the edge of your paper, and then you can make tags only with scissors, even if you have no cutting machine, by cutting along this line. Whoa, can you see that? Yeah, hopefully. You can cut it like this. And of course you don't need this onion dyed paper. Of course you can also use any paper that you have. So I will tell you in a second what this is. Yeah, and when you have this here in your hand, then you can take this prepared edges here and you can just cut this off. Don't move it. And now you have a really plain but useful tag. So yeah, of course you don't need such onion dyed papers, but I thought I would tell you this because I think the most of you will have paper, the most of you will have water and perhaps some vinegar, and the most of you will have perhaps some onions or other things. You can also use garlic or this red cabbage things, and yeah, make such beautiful things here to your paper. But of course you can also use this one here. You have a plain thing where you can work on. The next thing that I prepared here is I distressed the edges of these tags here because, yeah, I thought it would look really cute if they have this frame. And at the moment I'm in this mood that I love this darker distressed edges. So I used this tool here. And even if I know that it's no distressing ink, so my friend Angelika told me that this is not made for distressing, so it's not planned to distress with it, but I at the moment only have this ink here. So in the last video where I showed you how I made the envelopes from this, I said that you can distress with this ink. So I would like to correct that this is originally not made to distress, but it's possible, as you can see here. And you get a really dark and, I think, yeah, nice looking frame. So I love this thing when it looks like it's a little bit burnt or, yeah, something like that. Okay, so what I also want to say is, even if you don't have distress ink, you can use ink that is not made for distressing, because yeah, why not? You can also use some really dark coffee. So if you make your coffee, then yeah, you can take it and make it a little bit stronger. And then you can also take such a little tool or some of this normal sponges that you perhaps have in your house to clean something up or something like that. You can even tear a little piece out of it and then you can use it. You can use every sponge that you have. I think you can even use a paper towel or something like that to bring the ink to it, and then, or the coffee, and then you can do it like this and distress it. What you also could use is the rest of your onion water when you make this this onion dye. Then you can also take the used water to get some lighter distressing here. Of course, that will not be such dark as this is, but it will be possible. What you also can use is watercolor or acrylic paint mixed with water. Yeah, that are the possibilities that I thought about. Of course, I think there are many other possibilities. And yeah, so you can prepare this text. As you can see, I made some that have a hole here so that I can put a little ribbon or some strings or something like that through it. And the other ones I left like they were, and I didn't punch the hole. because I want to add some fabric here on top, and then I want to sew it here. The really craziest thing is, I have to tell you that because perhaps you say, oh, Luise, you are a poor girl. Sometimes I need to hear that. My sewing machine is there right out of the kitchen on my in the other room, but my sewing machine isn't sewing at the moment, and I don't know why. I had this problem a few days ago, then I solved it, and I was sewing, and as you saw my last tutorial with the envelopes, and yeah, everything went very fine and everything worked. And after this tutorial, my sewing machine said, okay, Luise, I don't have any mood to sew anymore. And so, yeah, I can't sew around here. But of course, that will also be a really cool thing. Even if you don't do anything to this when you have this result, even if you only sew around, then that would look really cool. You have some things to do. And later on, perhaps when you have more supplies, or yeah, you can go to your craft room, then you can put some things on here. And what I also did was I made some tags out of some things that were laying around here in my house. So let me just show you that. So these are the same bases. So this is also this onion dyed paper. And I did the same way. As you can see, when I did this, my sewing machine worked. And this here is not from my crafty stash, because this is, something that was really weird. I found this in the box of my Barbie dolls. So perhaps you know my video about my Barbie doll covers. And I found something, that's like an umbrella that has these things here around. So I've carefully cut that off and used it here for this little pocket. And this little fabric here is from a Barbie doll dress. So even if you don't have your fabrics or your, things like this little ruffles, or how is this called, perhaps you can find something where you don't expect it. So go around your house and search for things that you can use. And I know these colors are really strange, but when I put that together, I thought, okay, that makes me happy in some way, because these colors, normally I wouldn't use yellow and red together, but in this case, I thought that would be a nice idea. And on some, I only have sewn this here so that I can put some labels or something like that. And for some of them, I made those little pockets. And in here, I have this little, I think it's this way, sorry. I have this little Matchbox minis that I also have in my Etsy shop. So that's, of course, another idea when you want to prepare some ephemera for your stash. Why not using some digitals? So, of course, this is an advertisement, a little advertisement for my shop. So if you want those here, exactly those, you can find them in my shop. There are several sheets in one ephemera pack where you can, what you can print out and cut them, and then you have them. So I have to say, these are distressed with this really dark brown distressing ink. But of course, you can also leave them as they are. I think I don't have some to show you, but the original frame is not such dark like you can see here, but of course you can distress them or only cut them out or something like that. And I think you have some beautiful things for your stash. This is a little pocket, as I said, and you can put some things in here. Of course, you can also cut something out from some flower magazines or something from your junk mail. I think if you look around, you will find some things where you can, what you can put in there. And this one here is looking a little bit different. So let me just tell you something about that. In the background, this, what you can see here, this sunflower is something like a plastic. So this Barbie doll umbrella was made from this plastic stuff. And around there, there was this, this construction of the umbrella out of plastic. And I removed that and remove this little border here. And this one here was, yeah, the top of this umbrella. And I've cut it into this shape of the tag. So originally it was this onion dyed tag as well. And I've cut it and then I sewed it and then I attached this little pocket here. So, oopsala, when you put this here inside, you have a nice background. And yeah, I know these colors are really something like retro or something like that. Not something vintage, not modern, but yeah, something special, I think. I would like to punch a hole here later when I have my normal hand punch, but yeah, I can't do it at the moment, but yeah, that's the reason why it looks a little bit weird at the moment. But of course, you can also add something here. If you like that and if you have the patience to glue it, of course, you can glue the ribbon to this top part of the tag as well. Okay, so then I was here in my kitchen with my tags and I thought, okay, now I have tags. What's going on? What shall I do the next? And then I, had the idea that my neighbor, she's a really, really cute person. She is working in a library normally. So at the moment, of course, she's not at work, but she has, always she has some books and some stuff. I often got some old books from her in the past, and in her garage, I can see her garage from here, from my kitchen window. I know she has a lot of old books and stuff. She's often going to flea markets and she's also organizing some flea markets. And because of that, she has those books and stuff. So I thought, okay, I can't go through my garden to her and I can't ring the bell and say, oh, hi. Do you have some books for me? So I thought I would contact her per Facebook Messenger. And then she was the cutest person in this world yesterday because she went to her garage and searched for some things for me. And then a few hours later, and that was really funny because she said, oh yes, I have this and I have this and I have this. And I think she was also a little bit happy that she could help me because, yeah, she knows what I'm doing. She's always really supportive and yeah, she likes my posts every time and she knows what I'm doing. But of course, I can't expect that she's thinking about me and that she comes by herself. So I thought, okay, why not asking her? And so yeah, she came to my door and she put some, that's my coffee machine, sorry. I'm sorry, my coffee machine is making really crazy noises sometimes. Because she can't come to me in this corona situation, she collected some things and brought it to in front of my door and I could pick it up there. So that was really cute. So I got this envelope from her and this says that this is made like a surviving packaging against this situation that you have to stay at home. So that was really, really cute. And of course, I can use this really big envelope. So it's so big that I can't show you my camera for some crafty stuff as well. So it has this orange color here that I don't like as much, but perhaps we can do something with it in the future. And then she came up with some of those greeting cards. So she obviously has many, many, many of them. And yeah, I've sorted them by color and by the things that I am planning to do with it. And there were really, really cute things to fuzzy cut. So I said to her, perhaps you have some flowers or birds or something like that that I can fuzzy cut out and use for putting them on my tags here. And I just prepared that for you because I think that's a little bit boring to watch when I fuzzy cut these things here. So all what you can see here is just cut out from those greeting cards. And I think when you look in your shelf or somewhere else, even if you are not in your crafty area, You can find things like that. Even in the junk mails, sometimes you can find really beautiful images. So I just have cut out that. Then I found in my Barbie doll stash these little flowers here. So I thought perhaps we can do something with them. I have leftover of this little thing here from the umbrella, what I showed you on the text before. And I also found some of this red fabric here. So, yeah, as I said on this other text with the pockets, I think it's a nice color combination, even if it's, yeah, perhaps a little bit difficult to combine that with those vintagey and old looking stuff. But yeah, I think it's better to do something and be a little bit creative, so also for your inner mind and such things, than to do nothing because you think, okay, I don't like red. So I will try to do something with this. Then I have here the first thing, some leftovers of this onion dyed paper. So that was that stuff where the paper broke when I took it out of the water. So I left that here. And then I have this old book here. And perhaps you can find some old books by yourself. So perhaps in your shelf or somewhere else. Perhaps you can take a book that you normally would read, but when you would like to do some crafting, you can perhaps use it for that. Yeah, so this is really old, I think 1804. So I think that would fit very nice to this text here. So let me just take out a page here so that we have it here on hand. And my problem, my biggest problem is that at the moment I don't have any glue at my home. So I found a little rest of Mod Podge. So I filled it here into this little bottle that was, by the way, a happy accident as well, because I ordered those squeezer bottles on Amazon a few days ago, and now I have them here. So I filled this up with Mod Podge. Yeah, why not using that? I think it's a really expensive way when you glue your things with this, but better than having nothing. So I think I will order some normal glue on Amazon the next days. And what I also have, and I'm really happy about that, are my, ta-da, my Brasho colors. So what I would like to do is, I would like to make some unusual tags. I would like to do some collaging on them, but I don't want to make it like we see it every day, because yeah, I think those tags are really, really beautiful. And of course, you can do it like that, but I think I'm in the mood that I want to try something that I never did before. And for that, I would like to use some Brasho colors on this onion dyed paper, because I saw that never before on YouTube, and I never did it before, so I don't know what will happen. But I think perhaps it's a good idea to try something new. So I just pick up some of my flowers here. And I think my tags are a little bit too small for this whole stuff, but perhaps this journaling card, but that's not such beautiful on the front. Let me just check if I have another one. Yes, here. Perhaps this one. So these I only cut it into this normal, yeah, journaling card frame stuff. Don't know how to say that. Perhaps that can be a little bit better. And I don't care about these leftovers here. When I glue it, then I can cut it and use these leaves here for some other tags or something like that. And I think the main problem of this whole stuff is that all of those images that I have here are a little bit glossy. So this greeting card material is a little bit weird because the most of this stuff is glossy. And yeah, I don't know how that will look in the end when I combine it here with this older things and this, yeah, this book pages, I don't know. But yeah, let's see. So I just take my, when book pages are such old, I'm always a little bit afraid to tear them. But yeah. And when I collage this, as I said, I don't care about the things that are coming out of this tag, because I can cut that later and go over it with my distressing ink, or yeah, that ink that I have here, even if it's no distress ink, and finish this distressing there, so that it is also on this scrap, and yeah, that I don't have this cutting edge there. What about putting some of this? So by the way, that was a t-shirt here from the Barbie doll. So I think my mother or my grandmother has sewn that one time. Sorry, I need that for another thing here now. And I try to make it like this so that I get this really fuzzy and rough edges here. Just do it like a little bit like this. And I think perhaps we can do it like this. No, that's not so good. Don't know. So I think I will try it like this. I just place this stuff where I think that it can look good, and then I take it off, put this out of the way. And what I also have here is a water spray bottle. If you don't have that, perhaps you can find something in your cleaning area where you have your the stuff where you clean your house. Sometimes this cleaning stuff is in such spray bottles. Perhaps you can put the cleaning stuff, this liquid, out of it and wash it and then put some water into it. Perhaps that can be a good idea. So that you have a spray bottle, even if you think you don't have a spray bottle. And now I'm searching for some reds and perhaps a purple. Purple, where are you? In the colors, so in these colors of the flowers that I have here on my fuzzy cut image. This, yeah, that can fit. I think that's the only purple I have, or this one here. Could be this. Yes, let's try that. Then I, put everything out of the way. It's a little bit small here, this little table here, sorry. And I know that my paper scrap and the flowers are here on the right side, so I try to get some of the brushes to this outer area so that they will be shown in the end. And I like to give the water to the paper first and then the brushes, because I always have the problem that my brushes are flying away when I put them to the material first and then spray water. I don't know why, but I have these things here all over my pieces, and I don't like that. I don't know why I have this problem, because I saw that people do that the other way around, but yeah, I don't know. I always have this problem. And then now it sticks here to the water area, and then I can spray without that it, so it flies, don't fly away, don't flies. Doesn't fly away. I don't know how this is called anymore. So as you can see, sorry, it stays there. And I think that looks not so bad. Let me just bring this a little bit in the position that it was before. That's not such crumbly and wavy. I think I like some of this here. So on this darker areas, of course, it's not such visible. But I think that's not too bad. Okay, let's dry that here. And then I take the other one that I had here, and I think I will put only some little brush or things here on top, because this is very big. And yeah, let's see what we can do with the paper scraps later. So let me just bring some reds here. Okay, so that's really orange. Let me just check if I have another red, something like a darker red that gives it a little bit more contrast. Yeah, perhaps this one, I think that's the second one I have. Only a little bit darker, but darker. Okay. So I think I will not move this around very much, because I like those splashes and these patterns that are here, but I will just take off some of the water here, because we don't need it. And yeah, so I will just dry that here with my heat gun, and then I will be back. So give me a second, please. Okay, so here I'm back. What I can tell you about brushes on onion dyed papers is the following. This was, as I said, this heavier paper. No, this was watercolor paper. This was really cheap watercolor paper. It's a little bit heavier, but it's not this copy paper. I just see that here on the backside. The colors are really great, as you can see, hopefully. So the pattern and this structure and these little crystals from the brush colors, they come out really, really great. Even if you only use colors in the same color palette. So this both reds came out really great. But you have to make sure that you don't have too much water. I just realized when you have too much water, so here, my paper, I can feel that it's really thin, and it seems that it will break when I add more water or something like that. So I don't care about that, because yeah, here on the back side you can see that the brush color came through it, because the paper broke on this, in this area here. But I think yeah, that's not too bad, because when you glue something over it and you collage something, then it will be sturdy enough that it can't fall apart. So by the way, can you see this Easter rabbit here? So that's strange. I see an Easter rabbit here. So here's the head, here's the eye and the nose, and here are the both ears. Can you see that? Perhaps I can doodle something on him. Oh, I don't have a black pen. Okay, so let's go back to the front side of this thing here. And let's start with this one. So I just take my little thing here. So now it will show me if that works. And I see nothing is coming out here. I expected that, because these things were really cheap. So I just yeah, took this needle off. I think it's a little bit too thin, but this yeah, is great too, because it's not too much what's coming out there. And even if I close my half hole here from the punching, I will do it, and then I can, when this is dry, punch a new hole on in this area where this original hole was. So that's no problem, because I want this little bit to the inside of this tag. I think this red is a little bit too red. No, I think that's okay. What? Hulk? That's like this. And another piece of this page here on the bottom. Yes, I think I will do it like this. Of course, there are many, many, many possibilities, and please do it like you want it and like you think, okay, that's nice. Don't have to do it like I'm doing it here, but yeah. Okay, so let's give some of this glue here to the backside of this fuzzy cut image. And I like to do it like this, that I put some of it to the middle of this this material, and then I go over it with my finger so that I can bring the thin layer of this glue everywhere. The good thing about that is that when you later on press the piece to your tag, then no glue will come out of the edges. So when you have this thin layer that will stick, and nothing will come out when you press it down. And yeah, I think that's a good idea. So let's do it like this. I also like to press it with my hands like this, because then you have pressure but nothing will move until the glue is nearly dry. And when you use Mod Podge, by the way, you have to make sure that nothing comes out here, because it's a little bit glossy. But I'm just thinking about if I shall put this Mod Podge all over the place here later. So now, it looks like this. I think I really like that. Also with this white frame, it gives it a little bit, more light in this thing. And then I take my scissors and I just cut the leftovers here. And also this one here. And then you can see that the distressing, of course, here is a little bit missing because I glued something over it. So I take my ink pad that's not made for distressing, but I will use it for that. And I will just go over it here a little bit so that this distressed frame comes back here to my piece. Also here. And as you can see, the fabric is here on the bottom of this thing. And even if this ink pad is not made for distressing, I like to use it. I also go over this brush or things here, because this stays on ink. Stays on. That's the reason why the name is stays on, I think. It stays on many materials. So if you go over fabric with this stays on ink, as you can see, it distresses also the fabric. And I think with those normal distressing inks, that is a little bit a harder job. Of course, you could do some shading to these flowers now. Perhaps you have something like this Stabilo All Pen, or some black inks, some black or brown or gray. How is that called? This brush pens, this watercolor brush pens. So you could go around here and make a little shadow. That would bring this fuzzy cut image a little bit more out of this whole thing. But I think I like it is. I will decide later if I will do this shading, because even if I would do it, I have to let this dry. So I put this right under a heavy book here on my table so that it dries without waves. And then let's go to this one here. Hello, Javi. The video is not finished yet. I have to telephone with someone. Yes. Oh. Sorry, so that was the doctor. So here in Austria, this corona thing is really strange, because, so I think it's strange in a good way, because they call us very often. So the police and the doctors that are around here, they call us and they ask how we are going and what's going on, if we have some things with our health that's not normal. And I think that's a really good thing here in Austria. So yesterday I said, sometimes I'm a little bit overwhelmed about this Austrian country, because as you know, originally I come from Germany, but I think the Austrian politic and that stuff is reacting in a very great way in this time. So we have the feeling that, yeah, someone cares about us and about our health and such things. And also the police is driving around very often, and they are controlling if we stay in our house, and especially the persons that are tested positive, so that have this virus, they are controlled in a very very strong amount. Can you say that in this way? I don't know. So you know what I mean. And I think that's really a positive thing in this strange times. Because yeah, there are also some people who don't care about this thing and who think, okay, I can make a corona party or something like that. So I heard about many, especially younger people, that think, okay, I'm not in this risk group, or how is this called, and they make some parties or meet their friends. And I personally, I don't understand that, so I really can't understand that. And I think it's a good thing when the police and the politics of this country have a little control about that, and you feel a little bit better, even if you don't have anything. But I think it can happen to any one of us, and so it's a good thing when you have the feeling that someone is there for you. And if the case would come that someone of us gets ill or needs a doctor or someone like that, then we always know who we can call, and that the police and the other people are there for us. And I think that's a good thing. So let's just cut this off here. Some glue missing here. So when you have normal glue, please use normal glue. I think this Mod Podge glue is not such good for this kind of project, but yeah, don't have anything else. So I think something is missing here. I would just try to break this bigger image of this rose here a little bit up with this, perhaps this scrap here. As you can see, I fuzzy cut here around this image and in some of these smaller areas as well. But here it was too difficult because there is nothing white that is going into here, so that I'm a little bit afraid to cut this beautiful image. I could cut through here and then glue it back later so that I can fuzzy cut out those white spaces, but I am a little bit afraid that it would be visible, so that this cut would be visible. And so I try to do it like this, break this up a little bit. And by the way, what I prepared as well here in my little container of tags is some, I can't get them out, sorry, some of those little labels here. So I just cut some of those little things here from the leftovers of the onion dyed paper. And I'm just thinking about putting something here that's a little bit too big for me, perhaps like this. But let's just bring something with a color down below, so under it. I just have to check my things here. So I have another staple of the leftovers of the greeting cards and the envelopes, where I have fuzzy cut out these images. And now I'm trying to find something. Perhaps this little edge can be... no, that's too green. And I think when you have to use those things that you have on hand, it can be a challenge for yourself, because you have to live with that what you have. And I think that's not the the baddest thing, because you perhaps get some ideas that you wouldn't have had. Don't know if that is the right grammar of this, if you are not in this situation. So I think so this thing here that yeah, I have this frame here, but something is missing, so obviously missing there. I wouldn't do that when I do my normal crafting. So when I make these labels, when I have my normal craft supplies, I think I wouldn't do it in this way. But due to this situation, I think I just came up with an idea that I am, yeah, not tried out before. And I think that can look really great. And my neighbor who brought me this, these greeting cards and the stuff, said, okay, what you don't use, please throw it into your trash can. So I said, okay, there will be nothing that I will throw into my trash can, because yeah, look at this. I think that's really nice. I like that. So I don't know what she was talking about when she said, put the rest into your trash can, because there will not be any rest. So, okay. I think that's cool. And I think the main thing about this Corona crafting is that you are, yeah, that you are satisfied with that, what you came up with. So even if the people say, okay, that looks not such nice, I think that's not made with special tools or special materials. Don't care about that. So that's something I really would like to bring to you with this video. So in these times where this world is such crazy, I think the main thing is that you are satisfied with that what you are doing. So if you do some music, or if you do crafting, if you like to cook or bake a cake, it's yeah, it's up to you. But the main thing is to be satisfied and not to go crazy or go into this panic modus or something like that. I think that's the main thing, and that's also the main reason why I'm doing this here. Okay, so that's this one. Let me just bring this up. And I think we can be really happy with this. So I'm really surprised what this Brusho Colors did with this onion dyed papers, that they came out such bright. I think that's really cool. I will punch this hole here that I have, yeah, this complete hole there. Then I will put that under a heavy book. As you can see, this went, in this short time, it went to a really flat thing. So even if you use Mod Podge, so as you can see, the left one is not really flat, but I think with this book onto it, that will work. And yeah, I hope I could give you a little inspiration, and I'm really happy that you were here with me, and yeah, in this little crafty session. Hopefully I will come up with some other hashtag Corona crafting ideas. I have to laugh about this hashtag a little while. And yeah, until then, I wish you a really great time. If you haven't until now, please subscribe to my channel. Please hit this little notification bell that you get informed when I upload a new video. If you like to follow me somewhere, you will find all the informations down in down below in the description box of this video. I have an Instagram account, I have a Facebook page. So if you like to see more of my artwork, then you can follow me there. I would be very happy about that. And yeah, so, oh, one last thing. If you haven't subscribed to my mailing list, please do that. The informations are down below in the description box as well. I'm sending some newsletters out to the world, and there are several people who are following me there, so thank you very much for that. You will get some informations about my Etsy shop, some YouTube news and such stuff, some things that I am working on and some tips and tricks and such things, but you will also get some freebies in the most of the newsletters that I am sending out. So if you are interested in that, please check out the informations down below, click the link to my homepage and follow the instructions there so that you can subscribe to this mailing list. Yeah, so hope to see you soon and have a very great time, even if it's a really weird time at the moment. Stay healthy and stay at home, please. So see you the next time. Bye bye.